ChatGPT has reached over 100 million users in just 2 months after it launched, which is according to Google search data. The notable success makes everyone doubt if it is going to replace jobs anytime soon. Similar discussions have been made in the area of web scraping. The question, how will ChatGPT affect web scraping, was first posted on Reddit about a month after ChatGPT's launch. To answer this question, let's take a closer look at what ChatGPT is and what it can do for web scraping. What is ChatGPT? ChatGPT is a natural language processing tool developed by OpenAI. And another way to put it, a chatbot that's really smart. OpenAI has fed a model 300 billion words via 560 GB of plain text, including books, articles, Wikipedia, posts on the internet, etc., to train and enhance it. ChatGPT can greatly aid the writing, debugging, and interpretations of code, as well as the language translation. You can even ask questions like how to get along with people better. Will ChatGPT replace web scraping tools? The short answer is no. To use ChatGPT for web scraping, there are both advantages and limitations. While it is capable of providing helpful information, it cannot be used directly for web scraping. ChatGPT can generate code snippets for data extraction upon request, using a website URL as the target. It can also suggest which library to use for web scraping based on the example. For those who collect data using code, ChatGPT can enhance their productivity by saving them time on writing codes. However, it cannot directly scrape data from a website as it is only a language model. Therefore, to discuss whether ChatGPT can replace web scraping tools or become an alternative is like discussing if the color red can replace the fruit apple, and the answer is quite obvious. Web scraping tools are still indispensable. Nowadays, there are many web scraping tools to make web scraping easier for everyone regardless of whether they have coding experience. Taking Octopus as an example, it allows users to scrape data from any website within 4 easy steps. Step 1. Create a new task. Open the Octopus, then copy and paste the target URL into the search bar. The built-in browser will then begin loading the web page. Step 2. Select the wanted data. Once the page has finished loading, click Auto Detect Web Page Data in the Tips panel. Octopus will scan the page and highlight any extractable data. You may quickly determine whether the scanned information is wanted or not. Check them out on the web page and remove any unwanted data. Step 3. Create a workflow. After selecting all the desired data fields, click Create Workflow. Then, a workflow will show up on the right-hand side. It's a flowchart that presents every step of the scraper. Clicking on each action on the chart, you can preview how it works and check if it works as intended. Step 4. Run the task and export the data. Once you have confirmed that all the information is correct, you can run the scraper by clicking on the Run button. There are 2 ways to run your scraper: Local Run and Cloud Run. If you choose to run the scraper locally, you will need to keep your device powered on and in good condition throughout the entire scraping process to ensure the process won't be interrupted. Alternatively, by running the scraper on the cloud, your task will be sent to the cloud servers for continuous operation 24/7 without the need for a device to be switched off. After the task has completed, you can export data into an Excel, CSV, or JSON file, even a database like Google Sheets for further uses. ChatGPT is outstanding in the era of chatbots. While it can be helpful in many ways, including web scraping, for now, it seems too early to call it a productivity tool. For web scraping, there are many great tools for users. Check out our other videos to find out more web scraping possibilities with Octopus. Don't forget to give us a like if you find this video helpful.